ओके गाइस, हैप्पी इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। तो लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड द वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ थ्री फेज इंडक्शन मशीन। आई जस्ट क्विकली रिफ्रेश द प्रीवियस सेशन। दैट इज व्हेन अ थ्री फेज सप्लाई इज गिवन टू द स्टेटर वाइंडिंग, द स्टेटर वाइंडिंग इन स्टेटर साइड इट इज एबल टू प्रोड्यूस अ रोटेटिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। So, once the rotating magnetic field is produced, if you place a stationary conductor, that is rotor conductor, which is short circuited, and induce the EMF is produces as per the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, so that will create induced current in the rotor bar. So, as per Lenz's law, actually the current carrying conductor is placed in between, and deflection force is produces. That is what there is nothing actually. That is but torque. So this is how it's working. Okay, so initially we saw about in working principle, that is when our three phase supply is given to the stator winding, the rotating magnetic field is produced. So important thing, rotating magnetic field. So that is what we discussed in this session, rotating magnetic field. So as a name implies, rotating magnetic field is rotating. So how it happens, that is what we are going to discuss now. So in the previous class we saw about one video, that is in that video they just show that just a rotating magnetic field is produces when three phase supply is given. But this session we will discuss in detail, so please listen carefully. So when the stator of an electric motor where three phase winding is physically distributed to the stator core, in the stator core by 120 degree each, for example, so this is one winding, another thing is another winding is this one, and the another winding is like this means. So each are displaced from each other by 120 degrees. So that is what shown in this diagram, that is red, yellow, and blue. So these are the windings. So each winding, three windings. So don't consider all the windings, just consider only one winding. So red winding is displaced between the Y 120 degrees. Y is displaced with B by 120 degrees. B is displaced with red 120 degrees. So this is what the first initial state. Then second thing is magnetic flux produced by current in each phase can be represented by the equations given below. So we need to find the magnetic flux and resultant flux. So due that only the magnetic field strength we can able to analyze. So the formula for the magnetic flux is for the red phase, pi r equal to pi m sine omega t, and pi y equal to pi m sine omega t minus 120 degrees, pi b equal to pi m sine omega t minus 240 degrees. If pi m means m represents the amplitude of the flux wave. Okay, amplitude of the flux waves. That means in terms of sine wave, we can find the amplitude. That is what amplitude of flux waves, that is pi m. So here red magnitude is something pi m sine omega t. So pi y is this magnitude minus 120 degree displacement. Pi blue is magnitude of red with the 240 degrees. So how it is coming 240 degrees are means, so initially in the red phase it is displaces 120 and again 120 degree displacement, so it will coming around 240 degrees. So this is what the major and the main formula for finding the magnetic flux. So just consider this, just look at the diagram, what you will able to understand. This is simple sine wave, we know that, but how it is represents means, if you consider the zeroth instant, 0 point, you just taken the 0 point, red starts with the origin. That means the red phase is 0 degree. Okay, so next hello. Hello is starts in the negative direction at some particular point, that may be in the some magnitude. Similarly, blue starts with the positive one, positive value, and in the different points. Okay, so here as since we have three phase AC supply, we get three different phase flux values. For example, red starts with the zero AC supply, And yellow starts with minus 90 degrees or minus 120 degrees AC supply, and blue is again starts with minus 120 degrees AC supply. So this is how we can represent the flux wave for particular instant. For example, zeroth instant, red value is zero, y value is something, blue value is also something. But similarly, in this one first instant, the value of red is something. Okay, so similarly, the value of blue is also something, and value of yellow is also some other different value. So similarly, each instant three different fluxes values is available for three phases. So I will tell you how it's working. This is the first position, that is north pole and south pole both in 90 degrees, but this is somewhat 30 degrees, somewhat 60 degree like that. So just consider initially on the initially, if you consider resultant flux, if you want to find the resultant flux for all the fluxes, you just consider 0 degree. Initially omega value is zero, so that condition, what's the value, you will just find out. Pi r equal to, just simply substitute in this equation, pi r equal to pi m sine omega t. Omega t is nothing but zero, so sine zero is value is zero. Okay, so pi r value is zero. So similarly, pi y, if you substituting sine omega t equal to 0 in pi y values, you will get the value as minus root 3 by 2 pi m. So similarly, pi b will get plus root 3 2 by pi m. So these are the values of flux values of each windings. For red, it is 0. For y, it is minus root 3 by 2. For blue, it is plus root 3 by 2. So combine these three, all the three, we will get an average of resultant flux is 1.5 pi m. So this is what the value of magnetic field at time instant 0 degree. Okay, 0 degree la adoda resultant flux enna adoda magnetic rotating magnetic field irukkeengla adoda position enna அப்படிங்கிறது 0 degree அப்போ 0 phase அப்போ 3 phase supply கொடுக்கும்போது 3 different windings க்கு what is the value of resultant flux. So this is the first case. Similarly, if you are going for the second case, that is if you put WT equal to 30 degrees, you will get the value for pi r equal to 1 by 2 pi m, pi y equal to minus pi m, pi b equal to 1 by 2 pi m. So the resultant of these fluxes is 1.5 pi m. Okay, so previous cases we will get 1.5 pi m. So similarly, the second case is also will get 1.5 pi m. So adhula irundhu innor 1.5 m. So similarly, just look at the diagram, right side of the diagram, you just see that. So for each degree, the magnetic field position is going to change. For example, so this is what initial start degrees, maybe 0 degrees and 15 degrees and 30, 45, 60, 75, 90, like that. So each 15 degrees, the magnetic flux positions will be changed. So that is why the magnetic field is start to rotate. So this is what happens in the three-phase induction machine when a three-phase supply is given to three different windings. Any doubt in this? Yeah. So in this way, we can prove that due to the balanced supply applied to the three-phase stator winding, a rotating, or we can call that is as revolving magnetic field. So this is what a rotating magnetic field. Okay. So this is what each position, how the magnetic fluxes is changes.